So last week, everybody saw MVP attack me, and now he's in the list of a long, long list of people that have done that to me. There's Rated R, there's Beast, there's Pat, the Revolution. So it really seems like MVP has joined the Revolution, which is terrible for BYTW. But I'm not going to let you guys sit here any longer. MVP, get your ass out here now.
Anything you could do, I could do better. I can do anything better than you. Better than you.
I was the man on guard.
Let me ask you one question. Why do you think I joined the Revolution?
Well, for starters, you attacked me.
Every single person that got a title shot has attacked you. The Revolution, everyone. Wolf, Beast, whatever. Where's my shot? I have worked my ass off for the entire BYTW career. The reason I challenged Beast for this, for the spirit of competition, where's my title shot? Every single person that has attacked you has gotten a title shot. Where's the spirit of competition in that? I don't understand.
You want the truth?
Yeah.
Can't handle the truth, MVP.
Yes!
You want the truth? I'm going to give you the truth, okay? The reason why you haven't received a one-on-one best of BYTW championship match is the same reason why we've only had one match in the entire seven-year history of BYTW. We've only wrestled each other once. It's the same reason that Wolf hasn't picked you to have a best of BYTW championship match. It's the same reason why your only BYTW championship run lasted, what, 2 weeks? Shortest title reign in history. See, I'm going to lay a hard truth on you, and I don't know if you can take it, but you know what you asked for. MVP, you are a mid-carder who thinks that they belong in the main event. You sit here on your high horse and your Intercontinental Championship, it means nothing. My league blows your league out of the water. That's why we've only had one match. That's why Wolf hasn't chosen you for a number one contenders match. That's why the board of directors hasn't even decided that you deserve a number one contendership match or a championship match for that matter. I'm just better than you.
Wow.
You are a nothing. See, Wolf, me, Wolf, the main eventers, the board of directors know that I equal cash. You equal nothing. I equal ratings, you equal nothing. It's not even worth to build a pay-per-view around MVP versus Kibbles. It's not worth it. You're not worth it. I would squash you in a second. Oops. Pipe bomb.
About time he showed up.
How are you doing today?
Doing great. Have you seen what the Revolution's been doing?
Yeah. I'll admit, you're kicking our ass. We got more people than us, though. That goddamn sick around. We have more on us than we have on you. But I'll tell you what. Tonight, to make it interesting. Two guys from your side of the qualifiers versus two guys from my side of the qualifiers. So we'll do Pat, Beast, versus Crazy Clown, and Mr. Kibbles.
Oh, they got that. That's no concern at all. I have something for you, though, because I also went about making a match for you. You wanted to put me against one of my guys. So I'll put you against one of your best friends. You and MVP are going to be wrestling for the Intercontinental title tonight.
Look at that checkmate, sir. You have a good one. Now get out of here before
we'll see what happens.
Jam your teeth down your throat.
Right, here we go. Number one contendership for the tag team titles. It is Warren and Jason Sick versus Morbo and Crash the Monsters. And there's Morbo with a hard shot going right after Jason. You could see there over in the corner, we've got Ryan and Myers, who the other two members of Sick, standing there and watching as Morbo is locking a hard shot, and another hard shot in the abdominal stretch. He's got him up, and nice side slam by Morbo, bringing Jason down. But Jason's right back on the offensive here as he's got the arm twisted and he's just working on the arm and the shoulder. Oh, what a throw from Jason. Great throw down from Jason. Morbo's not really sure where Jason went there. He's trying to there's a hard shot as Morbo turns around. I'm going to remind you guys again that the winner of this match will be number one contenders for the tag team championships, and they will face Power Trip at Backyard Bash. I'm sorry, I'm messing up. I almost said our last pay-per-view broadcast to the world, but it's the Backyard Bash. Anyway, back to the match. And there's Morbo. Morbo with a hard round kick, knocking him down. And it looks like Morbo, there's another kick, brings him around, and knocks him down. A great, great maneuver there. One, two, no. And he kicks out at the count of two. What a great just double team. And there comes Crash down with the double team, getting Crash into this match for the very first time here. And Crash begins to take advantage and beat down on Jason. There's a hard clothesline by Crash. So far, I gotta say, there's the tag though. I think Crash took a little bit too much time. Once again, you can see the tag, their partners of Sick are watching. And there's a kick by Crash and brings him right down. A little bit of too much showboating, gallivanting around. And there's a 5-star slap to the back. And Crash, Crash with a big, big body splash. Knocking Warren down like he's absolutely nothing. And what's Morbo doing? He's pointing up in the air. I don't really understand what he's doing here. But anyway, Morbo's the legal man in the match. He picks him up. He's got him up on the shoulders. I get it now. He's doing the airplane spin. He was pointing up to an airplane up in the sky. I understand the airplane spin. And there's a big clothesline. Morbo taking Warren down with a big clothesline. I gotta be honest. Morbo had a submission locked in. But Jason, the other member of Sick, came in and just broke it up. But there's Morbo taking advantage once again. Gotta be honest, this has been mostly the monsters in this matchup taking full advantage here. Could be looking for a move here. Morbo could be looking for rock bottom. Could be looking for the rock bottom. You know, Morbo likes to do the rock bottom every once in a while. Very rarely do we see Morbo go for that move, but a great counter by Warren that brings Morbo down. He's got a submission hold locked in. He's got the arm bar locked in on Morbo. Morbo's trying to fight back up to his feet. And, there's Crash with a big push. Great tag team work there. Crash stopping his partner from tapping out. Morbo looking for the Scarlet Pumpernickel. And there's Jason attacking Morbo. Once again, just great tag team work from both of these teams, not allowing the other team to pick up a pinfall victory or submission. Go for one, two, and Crash breaks it up at the count of two. And, double DDT. There's a double DDT bringing Morbo down to the mat. Morbo's really got a tag Crash in here. He drops an elbow. He drops another elbow. And jumps up high. Drops a third elbow down after jumping up really high. And Morbo reverses back with a clothesline. Morbo needs to make the tag here. Come on, Morbo. He's got a little bit of momentum on his side. Yes, and there's the tag to Crash. There's the tag. Whoa, and Crash is coming at him. Hard shot with his hand. Oh my god, what a bulldog. Bringing him down to the ground. Could be diving headbutt time. Whoa, takes to the sky. Oh, there's the diving headbutt by Crash. Great diving headbutt by Crash. He tags Morbo back in. Could be looking for a double team here. He's got him. And Morbo jumps off. Oh, and there's a hard shot to the head. That's been taking a beating. Scarlet Pumpernickel. Yes, there it is. The Scarlet Pumpernickel. If Morbo can get the pin, that will be it here. And there he covered. 1, 2, 3. And Morbo and Crash become the number one contenders for the tag team championships.